गुड मॉर्निंग स्टूडेंट ऑफ क्लास 7। आई एम योर कंप्यूटर टीचर संजीत सर। होप यू ऑल आर फाइन। टुडे आई एम गोइंग टू कंटिन्यू द चैप्टर नंबर 4। ओके, एथिक्स एंड सेफ्टी मेजर इन कंप्यूटिंग। चैप्टर नंबर 4, एथिक्स एंड सेफ्टी मेजर इन कंप्यूटिंग। ओके, दिस इज द सिलेबस ऑफ द फर्स्ट टर्म एग्जामिनेशन एंड आई हैव ऑलरेडी कंप्लीटेड चैप्टर नंबर 1 कंप्यूटर हार्डवेयर कंपोनेंट्स, चैप्टर नंबर 3 कंप्यूटर वायरस, and today I am going to complete the chapter number ethics safety measure in computing. Okay, this is the content of this chapter. In my previous video I already have discussed some up to some unethical practices. Okay, and today I am going to continue from few more unethical practices. Next, safety measure while using the computer and internet and digital footprints. Okay, so now move on to the main topic. So the first topic is spamming. Okay, spamming. Spams are unwanted mails that are received in bulk from unknown source. Okay, unknown source. Spam mails are mostly advertising mails. Spam something included phishing mail too. In my previous video I already have discussed about phishing. Phishing means someone send you a email, okay, and asks to update his or her personal details such as user ID, password, transaction password and credit card details. The information is then used to access the important accounts and can result in identity theft and financial loss. Okay, this is called phishing. And such mails also contain virus, worms, trojans. Okay, most of the messages that do not include the email address of the individual in TOR smell spam mail. Okay, that means spamming mails, unwanted mails. Okay, unwanted mails. Okay, we don't know who is the sender. Okay, so spam means unwanted mails that are received in bulk form. Okay, bulk form unknown source. Okay, bulk form unknown source. Okay, and sometimes including phishing mails too, and also contain viruses, worms, trojans. Okay, and most of the messages do not include the email address. Okay, email address. So this is called spamming. Okay, and how to prevent the spamming? First is avoid giving your email address to website unless it mandatory. Okay, next is do not reply to any of the spam. Avoid reading mails from unknown source and delete them. Do not click on any of the links from email received from an unknown source. Okay, so these are the few guidelines. We have to follow these guidelines to prevent spamming. Okay, next is individual right to privacy. Okay, individual right to privacy. So privacy defines that right to individual user or organization to keep their personal data and information secret. Okay, privacy is a major topic of concern. Most of people what that their personal information should not be monitored by others without their consent. However, the present information technology enables people to monitor and collect personal data without the individual consent. Privacy means to keep their personal data secret. Personal data and information secret. Okay, personal data and information secret. So privacy is a major topic of concern. Most people want their personal information should not be monitored by other without their consent. Okay, the present information technology enables people to monitor and collect personal data without their individual consent. Privacy hindrance comes into the picture when personal information of an individual is used or shared without his or her permission or consent. Okay, uses of the internet and certain apps can be affect the privacy of an individual's data. Okay, so basically we don't share other's person information to the internet. Okay, so this is the individual right to privacy. Okay, we never share other's pictures, other videos, other information to the internet. Okay, next is guidelines to protect the privacy. Never share your login details to anyone. Okay, never share your login, any type of login details, with anyone. Never share your personal information on any website. Always set a privacy of your social networking accounts. Always install an antivirus software or firewall to protect your system and data stored in it. Always keep your system password protected. Always enter your personal information only on official site. Okay, and last is, do not click any link received on email from a stranger. Okay, so this is the few guidelines we have to follow when we are using the internet, okay, to protect our privacy. Otherwise, anyone can thief our personal information, personal photos, okay, personal details, etc. Okay, so we have to follow these rules. Next is software piracy. So software piracy refers to illegal copying, okay, illegal copying of software for the purpose of distribution or sale. It is the most common and widely spread form of computer crime. It is because most users prefer to use pirated copies rather than spending money or buying softwares. Software piracy is most serious problem faced by today's software industry. Okay, so mainly software piracy means illegal copying without paying anything to the company. Okay, so we have to use legal softwares. Okay, legal softwares. For example, we want to use Microsoft Office. Okay, and we need to buy the Microsoft Office from the official website. But if we use pirated Microsoft Office software, we have not pay for this pirated software. Okay, so this is called the software piracy. Okay, and we never used the pirated software. Okay, so and here you can see, to prevent software piracy, we have to follow some guidelines. Do not create copies of software for the purpose of distribution. Okay, always buy licensed CD from a renowned sellers and avoid using the pirated CDs. Next is, always use a licensed software. Okay, always use a licensed software instead of a pirated software. Download the freely available software online from their official website. Okay, so these are the few points, and we have to follow this guideline. Okay, next is intellectual property rights. Okay, so intellectual property rights refers to the rights of a person, okay, of a person or company exclusively to use its own plans or idea without the worry of competition, at least for a specific period of time. Okay, so for example, this right can include copyrights, patents and trademarks. Okay, copyright, patents and trademark. These rights may be enforced by court via lawsuit. This reason for intellectual property is an encourage innovation without the fear that a competitor will steal the idea and or take the credit for it. Such rights protect the information from the getting copied or pirated. Okay, so this is called the intellectual property rights. Next is safety measure to protect intellectual property rights. First is patent. So now, what is patent? Okay, patents are the rights grants to inventors that allow to make to exclude all others from making, using or selling their invention for a fixed amount of time. The time period of patent in India is 20 years. Okay, so this is called patent. Patent means मेकिंग यूजिंग और सेलिंग इन्वेंशन फॉर ए फिक्स्ड अमाउंट ऑफ टाइम ओके एंड द पीरियड ऑफ पेटेंट इन इंडिया इज 20 ईयर्स ओके सो दिस इज कॉल्ड पेटेंट्स. नेक्स्ट इज कॉपीराइट. The copyright law protects the rights to of creative people such as artists, musicians, programmers, writers, and authors to stop unauthorized or illegal reproduction of their work by others. The copyright of all of a work at least for more than 70 years. Okay. Next is trademark. Trademark is a name or a symbol that a company used on its products. This name or symbol cannot be illegal used by any other company. The validity of a trademark of India is for 10 years and can be renewed. Okay, so these are the very important three terms of internet. Okay, intellectual property rights. Okay, patents, copyright, and trademark. Okay, next is safety measure while using the internet. Okay, safety measure while using the internet. First is make sure that the information provided by you is true in every aspect. However, do not share your personal information like your address, telephone number without your parents' permission. Okay, so we do not share any type of personal information like telephone number, address, etc. Okay, next is always be yourself while doing any kind of online activity. Do not fake in any way. Avoid using fake email IDs. Okay. Always avoid fake email IDs. Okay. Next is never agrees to meet an online friend alone. Okay. Never agree to meet an online friend alone. If you have to meet a person, take an adult with you and arrange a meeting at public places like park and mall. Next is never open emails from unknown people or addresses. This may contain computer virus that can causes your computer to malfunction and you can lose your valuable data. Okay. Next is remember that not all information available on the internet is correct. Okay. Not all the information available in internet is correct. So cross-check it with multiple sources before using the information. Next, always make a regular backup of your data to avoid the loss. Next is always keep an antivirus software updated on your system. Next is make use of a firewall as a security system in your computer. Firewall is a network security system that prevents unauthorized access. Okay, so that means firewall protects unauthorized access. Okay, unauthorized access on your computer and network. It follows certain rules specified by the user and it is implement at the gateway of the network. A firewall actually establishes a barrier. Okay, barrier between the trusted internal network and unauthorized external network such as internet. So firewall is very very important when you are using the internet. Okay, next is always keep a strong password with a combination of alphabet numeric symbol. Okay, so when you create a password you need to use alphabet numeric means number and also use the symbols. Okay, always keep your password confidential and keep changing it frequently. Okay, so these are the few safety measures while using computer and the internet. Okay, next is digital footprint. Okay, so digital, you have already known that the meaning of the word footprint, which is an impression of a foot left on the ground. In similarly way, digital footprint means information about a person on the internet due to his or her online activity. So when we are working on the internet, the government always tracking us. Okay, so this is the same thing. Digital footprint is the information about a person on the internet due to his or her online activity. It includes the website you visited, emails you sent, and the information you submitted to the online services. there are two types of digital footprints, an active digital footprint and passive digital footprint. So first is active digital footprint. So what is active digital footprint? Active digital footprint includes data that you intentionally submit online. Sending an email leads to active the digital footprint. Since the data can be seen or saved by another person, the more emails you send and more digital footprint grows. Okay. Next is passive digital footprints. A passive digital footprint refers to the data left by the user online unintentionally. Okay. For example, when you visit a website, the web server locks your IP address. Okay, locks your IP address, which identifies your internet service provider and your location. We all know that what is the IP address. IP address means the address of your computer. Okay, so address of your computer. And a more personal aspect, you have your passive digital footprint is your search history, which is saved by the search engine while you are logged in. Okay, so this digital footprint is very, very important, and we have to follow some guideline while working online. Avoid accessing others system. Okay, avoid accessing other system to perform your login activity. So always logging on your own computer. Okay, don't use others computer. Next is do not log into unwanted website. Okay, so avoid the unofficial website. Always visit the official website. Next is always keep your information social accounting visible only to friends in all in your list. Okay, so in the social networking site, always hide your personal information such as phone number, photos, etc. to unknown persons. Okay, next is avoid adding unknown people into a social networking sites. Next is be careful while replying on any of the post. Okay, so these are the few guidelines all of you have to follow when you are using the computer in internet or social networking or using the internet. Okay, so you have to follow these guidelines. Okay, each and every guideline is very, very important. Okay, so I hope that all of you understand the unethical practice safety measure of using computer and internet. Okay, so but all of you have to read it very carefully. Okay, all of you have to learn each and every guidelines. Okay, all guidelines are very, very important, and I hope that all of you understand today's topic. Okay, so today I am ending my discussion here. In my next video I will start a new chapter. Okay, so till then take care. Goodbye and thank you.